Good morning, Art Putney Academy, and welcome to today's whole school assembly. Today is the 1st of February, which means we've made it through January, the days are getting longer and spring is on its way, so there's a lot to look forward to. The topic of today's assembly is communication. What is communication and how can we effectively communicate? I'd like to start today's assembly by looking at our religious quote. Our religious quote today comes from humanism. John Stuart Mill on Liberty said, "As it is useful that while mankind are imperfect, there should be different opinions, so it is that there should be different experiments in living." To me, this suggests that we should be celebrating diversity and difference. And it leads me on nicely to the pillar that we're going to be looking at today, community. As a community of around 800 or 900 pupils and close to about 100 teaching staff and support staff, we have an incredible skill. Between us, we can speak 70 different languages, which is really quite amazing. And that highlights to me the diversity of our community. Many of us come from different places, many of us speak different languages, we all look different, we have different interests, and all of these differences should be celebrated. The art of talking and using language skills can have a huge power in achieving great things. And no one says it better than Stephen Hawking. For those of you who don't know, Stephen Hawking was a world-famous theoretical physicist and a director of research at Cambridge University. He suffered with a disease called motor neuron disease, which left him paralysed and without the ability to speak. After he lost his ability to speak, he was able to communicate through a speech-generating device that operated with the connection to a single muscle in his cheek. He said, "For millions of years, mankind lived just like animals. Then something happened which unleashed the power of our imagination. We learned to talk and we learned to listen. Speech has allowed the communication of ideas, enabling human beings to work together to build the impossible. Mankind's greatest achievements have come about by talking and its greatest failures by not talking. It doesn't have to be like this. All we need to do is make sure that we keep talking." Our ability to speak and communicate and to listen, which is a very important part of communication, enables us to do amazing things, as Stephen Hawking said. And this leads me on to our British value of democracy. We are lucky enough to live in a democracy in the United Kingdom. And what a democracy means is the fact that the people essentially rule. We should have protection of our human rights. We should have equality, freedom of speech, and active participation of all people. If we look at our community at APA, it's generally quite a small group of people, if we look at the bigger picture, a group of around 1,000 people. And in that group of 1,000 people, we have people from all over the world, from all different cultures, all different walks of life, and we're actually a very diverse group. If we think about London as a city, that diversity grows even more. England as a country, the UK as an entire nation. And if we want to have an effective democracy and achieve great things, communication is essential. Effective communication is essential. Or the past year, and the coronavirus pandemic has brought about huge changes in the way that we live our lives, and more specifically in the way that we communicate. A year ago today, we would have never considered that we would be sitting here today accessing our lessons on Microsoft Teams, teaching our lessons through a screen. Coronavirus has caused us to have far more physical space between us, and it has taught us a lot about how we can adapt to communicate in different ways when our principal mode of communication, talking, is not quite as available. I think this past year has highlighted that communication is completely essential, and actually, more importantly, that effective communication is essential. I've picked out four things that I think I've learned about communication in the last year. Probably number one is the fact that effective international communication is essential. The coronavirus pandemic has hit every corner of the world. Every government is trying to tackle it. Every single person has been affected by it. And as a nation, as a group of nations, we have had to find ways to try and combat this problem. And I think one thing that we can see as quite an achievement of international communication is the fact that we now have three vaccines that have been produced in the past year, using the great minds, the companies, the governments of many different countries in many different parts of the world. And as a result, hopefully we are going to see our way out of this situation. I think we can also say that we've realised even more how integral communication is to everyday life. And like I said just a minute ago, we've had to adapt. We've had to adapt to learning online. We've had to adapt to working online. And never did I think that I'd have to spend Christmas Day with my family on Zoom, but this year that had to happen. And we do manage to adapt. I think we've also learned that there's actually no substitute for face-to-face communication. We can put alternatives in place and we can adapt. But essentially, when we're not with people, we can't tell exactly how they feel because we don't have the little nuances of their facial expression, of their tone and of their action. And on a slightly more negative note, I think that we've learned that poor communication leads to frustration, anger and upset. A lot of people in the United Kingdom would say that our government perhaps haven't communicated in the most effective ways. There have been a lot of U-turns, there's been times where there's not been very much clarity on the rules that we've got to follow, and that's caused a lot of people to feel quite angry or quite frustrated with the situation. So essentially, coronavirus has taught us a lot about communication. But what exactly is communication? Communication is, as it says, the words you say. It's what you say. Okay, it's those words that you use. But it's far more than that. On top of that, it's how you say them. It's the tone of voice you use. And it's also your actions. You can communicate with other people through actions. And one thing that we all have to consider is the fact that the way that you communicate has a huge impact on other people. If you communicate effectively, if you communicate with kindness, and you communicate clearly, you will have a positive impact on other people. And it's essentially your choice.
Sometimes I lay under the moon, I thank God I'm breathing, and I pray don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around, because
Your ability to communicate is one of your greatest skills, and everybody has that skill. As you go about your daily business today, and as you communicate with those you have around you, I want you to choose how you're going to communicate. Choose to communicate with kindness, whether it's through what you say, how you say it, or an action that you do. Thank you for listening.